Hotep Leo, welcome to your What's Going On Behind Closed Doors love reading for the month of December 2020. I am Cosmic Divine Tarot and Leo. This is for your Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Lilith signs. If it resonates with you, go ahead, hit that like, share, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notifier to know, and I will be uploading more messages for you, Leo. And if it doesn't resonate with you, then don't worry about that. I'm just going to go ahead and get you next time I do your reading, okay? Now, Leo, if you like this reading and you want to go ahead and donate to my channel, then please do. Hit on that link in the description box below and it'll take you on over to my Cash App, okay? And I appreciate you. Love. Now, Leo, like I said, this is your behind closed doors reading, so I got the divine doors out for you. And this is the card that came out for you. After shuffling about 100 times, okay? This is your door. Now, it looks like you have a whole bunch of light on the outside, but there is something going on deep inside this door right here, okay? It's like something deep inside. Let's see what it says. Birth. Wow. Here's your message. Another gateway appears in view. New life is unfolding with blessings for you. Leo. That tells me that somebody's trying to get you pregnant, baby. Okay, somebody's trying to get you pregnant, or somebody's trying to make you get them pregnant, okay? Or somebody is trying to have a new beginning with you that is fertile and, you know, full of, like, different gateways of bliss, okay? Now, we got these cards right here representing the pros and the cons of this relationship with this person, okay? Or the pros and cons of this person, period, being in your life, Leo. This is the sacred language of light, and this is the dark mirror cards. The pros is here. Now, the pros about this relationship is soul writing, okay? Soul writing. This tells me that this person has the ability to penetrate your soul with words that they write. They may be somebody who write you poems, or somebody who, whatever it is that they write is penetrating, or the words that they say to you is penetrating your soul, that it has the ability to rewrite or write on your soul feelings that you've never felt before, okay? This may be an angelic being that you're dealing with here, Leo. All right? Somebody that's descended from the stars, okay? So it's like either that's you or them, something that y'all are saying to each other or something that you're saying to them. However it is that you're representing yourself is penetrating this person's soul, all right? Now, the cons of this relationship is obsession and perchance to dream, okay? It seems like this person is obsessed with you, Leo. They're obsessed with dreaming about starting a family with you or just starting a life with you, okay? They dream about it all the time. They just fixated on it. Whatever it is that they're doing, they're just thinking about having a life with you. Wherever it is that they're at, they're focused on you. They could be working at school. They could be taking a shower. They could be doing anything. And they just dreaming about when you two can go ahead and create this new life together. Okay? So that's what's going on with that. That's the con of it. Because this person is a bit too obsessed with that right there. Okay? So let's go ahead and see if we can find the zodiac sign that you're dealing with, Leo. All right? Want to know what zodiac sign are you dealing with? This is the Barbary Zodiac Oracle cards. Okay. Get a few more shuffles and see what the heck can we find out about this person. This person is like, whatever it is that they're saying to you or you're saying to them is just going straight to the soul, man. It's going straight to their soul. All right, let's go ahead and see what zodiac sign you're dealing with. What zodiac sign is Leo dealing with behind closed doors? Okay, boom. The moon. Leo, this person is a very sensitive, emotional, soft person. So that's why when you say something to them or you express some type of passion, fiery passion because you're Leo, okay, this person is just wide open for it. They're wide open for it. You have a very captive audience, Leo. Whatever it is that you say, this person is like you're just writing on this person's soul. Okay? And they're just constantly dreaming about starting something with you or having a child with you. So this is a Cancer Pisces we're talking about. This Cancer is sinking their claws into you as much as they can, okay? As much as they can. This Pisces is just lost in a dream world about you, Leo. Now, what other zodiac sign is Leo dealing with behind closed doors? Let me see. Gemini. You're dealing with a Gemini too, okay? Somebody who has just two sides to them. They're like, you know, they can be very passionate, but then very cold, okay? Very cold and very mental and just detached and whatnot. They can also be very emotional, you know? It's like, it's something about this person. What other messages do we have for Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus? Wake up, family. What other messages? Okay, Capricorn. Capricorn's coming out a lot. Capricorn getting around, man. Capricorn is somebody who is like very much into the sexual aspect of this relationship. They're very cardinal. They're very much into the materialistic aspect of it too. You know, they're very much, you know, earth sign is very down to earth. All right, so you're dealing with the earth, the air, and the water element. All of these cards represent their other signs too. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. Okay? Okay, now Leo, I got this new deck called the Decameron Tarot, all right? And I crack it open with you like I crack it open with everybody else. And Leo, I just got to tell you, like I told everybody else, I'm going to go ahead and give you a warning about these cards. These cards are very vulgar, you know, they're very, very sexually dominant. Now, if you're not new to my channel, you already know that I'll be giving these type of readings. But if you are new to my channel, first of all, welcome to my channel and thanks for stopping by. But these cards are very sexually, you know, explicit. So I'm giving you fair warning about these bad boys. All right, Leo? Now, let me go ahead and get you one more shuffle, baby. Cut the deck and let's see what's going on behind closed doors with you and this person. What messages do we have for Leo? Whoa, okay. Leo. This is the Eight of Chalices. Okay. Like I said, Leo, a very captive audience, okay? This person is very captive of whatever it is that you are saying to them. You know, you could walk up to them and just put your fingers all in their mouth, okay? Or this person can do that to you because what it is that you're saying, all right? What it is, the words and the energy that radiates from you. This person want to go ahead and come up to you and pull your dress down or your shirt off and put their fingers in your mouth. Like, they want you sucking on their fingers because they are just fixated on you, okay? The things that come out of your mouth, they just want, you know, they just want to feel, they want their fingers, their body to feel the liquid that drips from your tongue, okay? Let me go ahead and get you another message. Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Lilith, this person. Okay. Ooh. Ooh. Ace of Wands. Leo. Okay. This person holds on to your wand, your phallic, for dear life, okay? It's like this person right here is wrapped around this phallic because it's like they are so in love with it. It's like this person is in love and obsessed with your phallic or obsessed with your kitty, but this is the actual phallic here. Okay, it could be for the kitty too, because the, like I said, a woman has an inner phallic, okay, inner erected phallic. Okay, so it's like this person is obsessed with it, obsessed with, you know, the tip of it. Okay, so they just like doing and touching and kissing on the tip of it. All right, so that's deep right there. They want a child with you too, so that's why they like to stimulate this tip. Okay, like to stimulate it so that you can go ahead and give them the seed that they need. All right. Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Okay, now here we got this card right here, the Ten of Chalices. So this person is like somebody who would be all on, like I said, stimulating the tip. And I'm talking about the tip of the male and the tip of the female, okay? To the point where, you know, you on the bed getting all kind of oral pleasure from this person and you're backing up like, wait a second, you know, this is, they just on it too much, you know? So you back up so much that you fall out the daggone bed, Leo. You and fell out the bed. You're like, okay, listen, you know, this is just too much. Or you got this person falling out the daggone bed, you know? They're just gone off of the sexual pleasure that you give them, right out the bed on the floor, and then they still saying what you want on the floor. What? Okay, come on, here we go. Boom, got the Hangman. It don't matter if you on the floor, baby. It don't matter if you on the floor. They still up in that kitty. They still sucking on that wand right here, because we got this person doing both things here, okay? This person on the wand, that person on the kitty. So it's like this is male and female that I'm talking about here, Leo, okay? It don't matter you went on the floor. This person went ahead and chased you on the daggone floor with your legs open and still in it. And still in it. You ain't getting away from this person. You're not getting away from this person. Okay, what we got here? We have the Five of Pentacles. The Five of Pentacles is somebody reading a book. So I'm thinking that this book is like a book that teaches you about the erogenous zones of a person's body, okay? This book is something that teaches you how to go ahead and sexually pleasure somebody. This person, or you, I'm going to say, I don't know which one, Leo. It could be you, it could be them. But one of y'all have learned the arts, okay? You learned the arts. You did your studying. You did your work. You put your work in, and you know exactly what to do to cause the other person to be in complete and utter ecstasy. All right, Leo? Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Here we go. Four of Wands. Four of Wands. And, you know, you're celebrating the fact that you know how to go ahead and touch this person in a way that, you know, is causing them to flare up, you know, flare up the fire. This is somebody doing this to you, Leo. I'm feeling this somebody doing this to you. Somebody unstudied something, you know, this Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus with the Pentacle energy right here. Okay, this Cancer, Pisces, Virgo, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, I mean, has done the Ten of Chalices on you, okay? So it's like this person with the Gemini energy, with the mental energy, has studied the art of having sex, okay? Studied the art of satisfying and pleasing and being all over somebody's body right here, okay? That's the Four of Wands. This could be your twin flame. This could be your twin flame, but it's definitely celebrated that this person know how to get up in it. Now, here is the King of Swords. The King of Swords, okay? With this bare belly, you may be dealing with somebody who got a big old belly, okay? Or maybe dealing with somebody, you may have a big old belly and they're skinny and whatnot, but you, that don't mean a daggone thing. Oh, you're still up in it, okay? Yeah, they still going to be up in it, Leo, okay? Deep up in it with this very strong phallic, because the sword is a strong phallic energy. And you're just going to have to go ahead and speak the truth about how deep this person is all up in you, Leo, all right? Mm. What are the messages we have for Leo? Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Lilith. All right, now here we got the Emperor. Okay, the Emperor. All right, this is a strange card here. What you're saying to this person is imagining. See this little person right here? This, they're imagining y'all having a little person, okay? They're hugging on to you for dear life. And it's like, you are thinking like, you don't know if you want to go ahead and have a child by this person. You see the Emperor's face? The Emperor look like, you know, they're just in shock right here. Or they look to be like encaged or something. They may not want to have a child, but this person got their breasts on each side of the neck here. That also may be it. That may be the reason why they're in such, surprise here, because this person will just be putting their body parts all on you, Leo, hoping that, you know, you go ahead and release the seed and they can go ahead and have a baby. All right, now go ahead. Let me see. What other messages do we have for Leo? Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Okay. Eight of Wands. As you can see, the wands look like penises. Okay, so, yeah, this person on the table, okay, all up in the kitty. Just all up on the wand. They're just all over you, Leo. They all over you. They're like, you know, they're giving you so much sex because they want you to give them a baby. They want to trap you, and you're thinking like, man, maybe this person wants to trap me, and I don't need to be around this person. Maybe I need to go ahead and leave this person alone, Leo. Love Oracle cards. You're like, man, look, I'm falling off the daggone bed. I'm walking out the room or walking somewhere, and this person got their fingers all in my mouth. I wake up in the morning, this person got their daggone body or their legs wrapped all around my leg and face down there with the wand or their hands down there with the wand. It's like this person is like amazing. They're amazing. I mean, you loving all of it, Leo. You're loving all this attention. You just don't know if you're ready to have a baby yet. You don't know if you're ready to be pregnant or get this person pregnant. You just don't know that, Leo. Okay, let's see what the Love Oracle cards got to say. What other messages do we have for Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus? All right, heartbroken. Okay, deeply hurt, sad, separation, breakup, feeling lost, grieving, and mourning. It could be saying you don't know if you're going to be able to stay with this person, or is this person only utilizing you for getting them pregnant, or you getting pregnant, all right? This person you may have to heal your heart from this person. Got healing from heartbreak, freedom from toxic relationship or addiction. Maybe you need to go ahead and set yourself free from this person. Or this person just has you thinking like that, Leo. Just have you thinking like, you know, maybe this person is only after my seed. Maybe this person is only after my sex. Now, here we got the Axe here. There's a whole bunch of breakup, separation, stop the pattern, silent treatment, and abandonment. All right? So, yeah, it's a lot of breakup here, Leo. Somebody is very scared. It could be that Cancer, Pisces is scared that if they don't, if they don't get you pregnant, or if you don't get them pregnant, then it's going to be a breakup. Maybe there's like some type of rift in your relationship, and this person is just constantly wanting to have sex with you to try to heal the rift and get pregnant and trap you, Leo. Now, here's a magical mindset. Everything is divine. Know that you are the creator of your reality. They're trying to co-manifest with the universe. They don't want to be heartbroken. They don't want to separate. They don't want to give you a silent treatment. They don't want you to give them a silent treatment. And here we got the mirror here. The mirror is telling me that maybe both of y'all are feeling this way about each other. Maybe you don't want to get them pregnant because you don't want to be separated from them. And they want you to get them pregnant because they don't want to be separated from you. Alright, so it's deep right there. It's deep going on here. It's like some type of conversation needs to happen here with y'all. Some conversation needs to happen here with y'all. Y'all need to go ahead and express how y'all feel about what's going on here. You know, this person need to go ahead and be open. The King of Swords is somebody who is a honest person. They need to be honest why they are all on you like this and why they want to get you pregnant or for you to get them pregnant, okay? That's what they need to be honest about. And once y'all are honest about this whole daggone thing, then that's when things are going to get better for y'all. Things are going to get better for y'all once y'all be honest and stop, this person stops hiding behind the sexual desire. Once they stop doing that and once they start, you know, showing their real feelings as to why it is that, you know, they're doing this, then it's like, okay, you understand, Leo. I mean, you get that. You're Leo. You know, you understand why somebody would want to go ahead and trap you because, you know, you're awesome. You're awesome. And they know that you're awesome. Okay? And it's like, you know that they're awesome too. So it's like, just go ahead and talk about this. Go ahead and have this conversation and go ahead and pour your heart out to each other. And then go ahead and heal this whole thing and then start having sex for the right reasons. Okay? Or it could also be saying that maybe y'all broke up and now this person needs to heal the heart from the separation. They manifested you back into their life and you manifested them back into your life so that y'all can heal each other. Okay? Through the sexual act. All right, Leo, that's another way of saying it. Leo, if this reading resonates with you, then go ahead and hit that like, share, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notifier to know that we'll be uploading more messages for you, okay? Now, if it doesn't resonate with you, don't even worry about it. I got you next time, Leo. Peace, love, and light, baby. Hold up.